Indy 2 Roger, play the line blocker. Indy 2 Roger.
13.
Indy 2 Louis.
Indy 2 Louis. Block 33.
Did you ever run that number, Sam?
I was in the gap.
The biggest reason probably for the side adjustment.
Oh, it's easy for them to see those guys. No.
That's the main ones. Those are the big five. Other than the short yardage stuff, you know, we run the sweep and all that. Now we do the speed option, something we're going to probably run more often or need to run more often. The speed option for us will always run to the weak side. So, trips or real, whatever, we're going to run weak. You can run out of ripping lids with man coverage, but where are you going? We're going to call it as original play call. It's either ram in line or real lead, and we run it to the open side. As I mentioned yesterday, you can only run any weak side run with three guys weak. Now, if you get those four guys over here, we ain't running.
You got three guys over here, we'll run.
Right. But there are some rules with that. Right. If the wheel linebacker is outside the guard, we can't run. Unless he's on the line of scrimmage. If he's on the line of scrimmage outside the guard, then we'll pitch off of him and we'll block it. He's on it. We'll pitch off the wheel. We'll full zone it if we have a wheel outside. If we have the wheel in there, now we're going to block it this way, pitch off the end, zone the backside. And catch the ball, we come downhill right now, and the back gets in a pitch relationship. I don't know much about option, but we tell them 4-1. 4 yards behind me and 1 yard in front. And always keeping that 4-1 relationship. And that being so we want the back to run through the pitch. In other words, we want him to see the pitch, the ball in the air, and be able to run through it. As opposed to, you know, sometimes the pitch is behind him, you know, whatever. We want him to be able to. So he's going to back up. Our back has to do this speed option. Our back is actually doing this. And then coming downhill and running through the pitch while the pitch is in the air and catching. Back catches it, goes right now for the outside hip and pad. Pitches off again. We don't run with a too deep look. We don't want to count on that block, even though it's good. It's just, we want to run, and for us, it's usually a check. Man coverage, wheel linebacker on the line blitzing, or wheel linebacker. If the wheelie linebacker's up here, we'll run that too. Block here, and there we go. Can't get to the mic, well, we might be able to. There's only one on the backside. Speed option, but always run weak. Now what we see sometimes, some teams are running, is that bare front. You probably play some teams that run a bare defense, they don't run a bare no matter what. Bear defense, if you line up against, you can't run the zone against that. You can't run the trap against that. You can run the power, right? It could be tough. Right? You can't run the zone. You can run the draw, but it's man block. You can't block the linebacker. The only plays is really good against this. You can run the counter, which you ain't run the counter very much because we need it way down on the list. You can run a little bit of power, but the speed option is the best play to run against the bear. Speed options and do that. To the backside back and cut off that off of the zone. Pitch off the end. So this bare defense, what coverage is it? 9 times out of 10. Man free. So the only guy that can help you is that free guy can run a speed option. Alright, that for us was 18 or 19, 18 to the right, 19 to the left. All right. That was awesome. 18 and 19. In other words, Orange Louie is 19. Or quarterback say Orange Roger is 18.
The Orange gave him like another.
It's just another way to call 18 or 19.
What's that?
This is my favorite board. When we signal it as the original call, speed opposite was this.
Looks like here comes the opposite.
Yeah.
Ain't worried about it.
Yeah.
What about draw real quick?
That was draw or Indy 2. Draw or Indy 2.
Okay.
You
can go there.
Yeah.
You can do it.
It's whatever, yeah.
And speed option. Good play.
You could also run a speed option. We ran this when Sean broke his wrist, his left wrist. We couldn't run the speed option to the left because he couldn't pitch with his left hand because he had a cast. So anytime we were going to run it to our left, we had it as a shuffle option. We blocked it the same way up front. He would catch it and shuffle just like the power shuffle and read off the end. So if you don't want to get your quarterback hit as much, you just do the speed option as a shuffle option. So we would signal that like this. Primary way to do it is to put it back down, move back, back up, but you can shuffle it as well. If I had an unathletic quarterback, I would shuffle it. Because you want the ball to get the backhand. But you'll be up to be, especially the Bear defense, because the Bear defense, one thing about the Bear, you got to coach defense. That's some bitch the Bear defense better be what? You better be a contained dude. If he ain't contained in, then they're in a world of shit. They're in man coverage out here, and then a Mike linebacker, and that's all they got. So they got 2-3 techniques in the Bear, is they have to be wide and outside. So you know, those ends of Bear are usually wide ends. So that means it's usually going to be a pitch.
Coach, we see a lot of 6-1.
You know, what I've been telling the quarterback that we're doing that is when we get that wheel displaced out there, when he removes.
That's when we want to run the shuffle because that end's gonna come up the field and we're able to seal that, you know, that middle linebacker easy with a tackle.
Talking about 4-wide?
Well, it don't matter. You know what we're looking for, like with JT out there, most people are gonna displace that middle linebacker.
Put him out there.
Yeah, and then they'll have a 6-1 inside, they'll have a 5, they'll have a 2 or 1 there, and they'll have a middle backer over the center. That's when we're running the shuffle right there. We're going to just flash that in and then go seal that back. And then we're coming outside.
Is he going to go get him?
Yeah.
Who's blocking him?
We just had a guy crack on him. We're running the shuffle.
You want to shuffle on me?
Yeah. So that end will come up the field.
If that ends up the field, then yeah, they're screwed up.
That's the defense we see more than anything at 6-1. Everything.
Usually guys that I would think to be sound in the 6-1, just be better come here.
Should be the 4 technique.
Yeah, 4. He might not up in 5.
Yeah, that's what we
play out. How he comes on
that. Play around. Yeah, that's the way our defense basically did all spring. And you'll see it on tape. I mean, they have twists and slams moving. Oh, there ain't nobody ever standing still.
Yeah, you know, that's what we
they got him right here.
Yep.
And they'll do this and this. Or they'll do.
Yeah, I see
this
playing on
this.
They got outside. I see it playing on this.
We saw them bring 2 outside on us. The shuffle option.
They'll bring you Monday.
They'll do it too.
Well, I won't do it, but playing on Easton bring you Monday.
Yeah. Our defense was setting 2 outside on us a lot. But the power, because we were doing, they were running this and this.
Right.
And we was running the power shuffle. We were caving him down and shuffling all that guy. It was all over. And so they started running a little easy stunt when they were bringing him. Wide and him underneath.
See that in spring.
Yeah. You know that crazy stuff.
Yeah. Used to do it from a standpoint, you know, they know that's a weak gap in there if they don't bring that guy under. That 5 they
bring somebody
him
under.
They know it's a weak
that's
gap.
The shuffle always takes you a little bit tight like shit. But that,
Ross,
that
what's up, man?
That was the 6th play for us. See, our sweep and our short yard stuff, but I think it's pretty good for us. Just because we're not in very much, and I don't think the team's prepared much.
Oh, really?
Just in a
six or something, so you get.
Yeah.
We'll understand.
And now, they put the bike line back over here. You go the other way.
We're in the athletic center and upstairs, and then I'll set a feet.
We want to run to 4-man side.
I would enter that lot.
1, 2, 3, 4. And for the bike over there, it's 5 guys. All we do, this is called R type and L type. R and L for us is pro set. R type and L type is pro set with tight and tight.
Okay, sounds good.
It's called R type sweep. And all I do is look for where the 5-man side is, and we run opposite.
Sounds good, man.
That's
but
y'all are having enough short yards that we're in the midline, I think.
Yeah.
So, that's the
deal, man.
That's the run game.
Set.
You don't have a zero though. You don't have any zero. Unless you, I guess you can go into zero.
Yeah, I just got that for a run.
81, 82, 83, 84, all at 10. We went to, I'm going to lose 11.
11.
Indy again was just, that's just another way to call. In other words, you want to have your Indy, the ones you're going to call them up.
Because you're sitting there going, you're going to say you go Indy 4, Indy 4, and you make a Roger Lucy, you don't. It's another way to call
right.
The foul without having to call
26,
you know, 46 or 47.
Right.
You know, I like it. You want to take a bathroom break 5 minutes? We'll go back and start to
watch a little bit of tape.
Yeah, let's watch some tape. You want to see, do that? Do that signal yourself? How do you call it par? We call it rip par like that.
I just call.
Do you like that?
I guess.
Yeah.
Let's rip par.
Sure do like that, Mike.
This far, and then rock. Rock.
Right. And lasers don't go down below.
Right. Lasers going down.
Got it.
And as soon as it just, actually the drop in age here is on blitz and drop in age. Line the 5-man protection cut. We'll run through the nuts.
You have a lot of people spotting the ball a lot in practice and stuff.
Yeah, we have managers. We have 2 managers that are put a striped shirt on, and they spot the ball for me every time. They're pretty good. They're good at the games, too, the away games. They travel with us. And you watch our away, if I don't have any of our away games, as soon as the play's over, you'll see them 2 old boys sprinting, handing up all the fishing. we want them spot as fast as can. We don't want them waiting around to have, for the ball when he gets the ball. So they, when that play's over, that fit, those guys are sprinting. And they get the ball and fish right there ready to play. So we have a rule too, we call Kansas City rule, because the Chiefs are one first we heard it off of. Any guy has a ball, it's running back, quarterback, wide out. When you get tackled, when the play is over, you're not allowed to set the ball on the ground.
Give the ref.
You got to answer the ref.
That's good.
There ain't no ball. I was down. No, you hand the ball to the official. Whether you score in the end zone, whether you get tackled, it doesn't matter. Spot, you hand the ball to the official. See what happens right here? Here's a good picture of it. The play is over. Right now, I got all me automatically starting. He's starting to look to find the signal guy.
We got a copy of this tape, Danny?
Yeah.
This one is yesterday?
Where'd yeah. you put that at? Did you give it to me?
It's in your office.
It's on my bed.
It is. Okay. Right, see, here's an example of pretty good timing. We're going live to the boundary. See, the umpire step away from the ball, we're already ready. Now, this guy's looking lazy. But he's giving the leg kick, and they're still getting lined up. We called, this is a line to the boundary. We're calling to the boundary. Power. We're probably going to end it, too, because it looks like we're going pretty quick as far as line up. And so he's going to call, where he's going to call the line? Away from formation. Call it to the wide side of the field.
Guard's
26.
Guard screws up right there, doesn't
it? Yeah, he does supposed to plus pitch off the end there on line screen. They twist and gets confused, but his eyes should be, if he has a guy on out on him and outside, that tackle's gonna make a wet call. That'll let him know. Well, this tackle ain't making a wet call, so his eyes should never be. His eyes should stay down on the second level. If he hears a wet call, then he can expect to find his guy on the line of scrimmage. So without a wet call, don't be a dumbass. Now, that can see what happened when he was blocking right. It went to the safety. And here's the safety jumping up in him. Oh, that's a little cute there. I don't know what was called originally, but he's calling black. You can see. Oh, he's tapping. Hooks was called and tapping. So it was rip formation, and we gave him hook signal. So all was called right here was rip, 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 hook. He called it a line. 60, 34, whatever, 60 something. We got press coverage, so we gave him a conversion to tap the outside guys, so now they're going to run verticals instead. But his timing told him three and throw on hooks, so still three and throw on the fade of his first one. One, two, three, throw. I don't know why I did the MRX right here.
How far are you throwing the tap down the field?
Well, it depends. If it's hooks tap, that means it's a vertical, and the guy's going to be 15 yards before he looks. If it's a hitch tap, that's a catch and throw, so the guy's going to be 10 yards before he looks back. So you tell your wideouts, if it's a hitch and we convert the tap, there ain't no use if we look back to you at least 10 yards. This quarterback can catch and throw. If it's a hook tap, you know, where he has a drop back, then you guys will go at least 15 yards before you look back. This quarterback ain't going to get through the steps with that. So, he's tapping right there. Six-man protection, the back is wrong. My six-man protection, the back's got in, the tackle's got in. Back block, the tackle's got in. The center's got these three. So that's why the center and these guys working on the twist. They've got these three. He would call here, we'll get an ABC call. A, B, C gap. Response to A gap, C gap, C gap. His A gap went away, so those two should bump off the twist.
Sure,
yeah, they
do. What's the protection? What's the protection?
Six-man protection, 660. And two out of bounds. Terrible. middle screen to the wide, 50 wide. And there's zone drops. He got the big call dropping out of the woods right there with his hat up there on jabs. Problem with this is the guy responsible blocking him is the right guard. He's going to set and cut the end. He don't do a good job. He ain't set and cut. He's cutting them online. He's going to set on our screen. He's going to set. Their rule is set, punch, release. We don't give 1,000, 1,002. We tell him set, punch, release. Set, punch, and then release flat. He blocks the guy on the top of the wide. The center will set, punch, release, and block the middle linebacker. The left guard will set, punch, release, and block the backside backer. And the backside tackle is the peel guy. He'll go 1,001, 1,002, and then he'll peel and block the first D line. Open right. Get the signal for open. And all across, all the plan was rocket, arrow. Get a rocket signal, get an arrow signal, rocket, arrow, rocket, arrow. Rocket's 5-minute protection, arrow is a route package. He's got an arrow, he's got a bow, he's got a bow outside of vertical. Linemen are up. Any type of full wide open formations, are there a 2-point stance unless the quarterback says under. He says under, he's under center, they get down 3-point stance. Leo, see him looking over about this, he must be a trap. He's looking over and it's Leo formation. And he's going to give him a Xerox signal.
Now this was a little slower here. Sometimes it's a little slower.
Yeah, if he's not sure, check, if it's not Indy. Yeah, he right here, what he's got a side.
Well, Indy, when that guy pulls off that ball, we're ready to snap it, right?
Yeah, but he can still change the play on Indy, too. Like, if it's a bad play on Indy, we don't want to run it. Now, if they're blitzing, you got to run. They got a third goal coverage in, we got to run play ball. No play or something. You don't want to run it. But we'll still check out if Indy plays. But we'll check a lot faster. But right here, they're zone blitzing, and they're playing cover four behind it. We treat it like cover zero, so you can see the guy step up and they start to step back. What we should do is we've got an uncovered. We ought to check lob before we just give them a lob signal. Mike's walked up. That's why he's wanting to know. There it is, the one we showed you. Ram over, limbo, limbo. Hurry up, snap. Tempo is pretty good. All right. Let's do it. Go a little bit faster. This guy wants to jump. Of course, he knows the play. Good practice needs it all week. No, don't let your ex go get the play. We want to throw the out, but if they jump the out, you don't want to force that.
It's the bow route, right?
Yeah. It's a little bow right there. See, that's the only thing I'm always pitching with these guys. At. See how there's wideouts are ready. See how they're still getting down. Yeah, they're getting set. They're too lazy. You know why they don't get down their stance? They're too lazy. It's always the fat boys that always screw you up. They haven't given the ready for play yet, but still, I don't want to be waiting on them. Now he gives the ready for play.
That's universal because it's the same way here.
Now we're going Indy 9. Now we're in pretty good shape. He's completely ready for play. This is the grease package. Come on, get off the athlete. Get off the guy. See, this X is wrong. He's got an X option. That wheel blitz, he got a slant. See that slant right there? We pitch and catch and throw the slant.
How fast is your Z out here?
They're all slow coaches. He's five flat. He's 4A.
That's at number six, isn't it?
Yeah, why do you got? He gets problems.
What's that number? Number three guy running on that?
He runs an eight step out, which is about 14 yards. We can plant a tree in the middle of the field, he'd run right into it.
Do they ever adjust a rest corner where the backers play leverage role, coach?
No, they'll just read it. If that guy's got an eight step out and they got a flat defender sitting out there, he'll just stop and hold. Ram. It's ram. Yeah, what do we call this?
336.
336, right? Here we probably call it Indy 7 Roger. Right? The back goes off, makes a fade, goes right off the B gap. You have a little carved up the knee carved right there. Block down, that gap. And the guard's pulling for support. He's up the field, so you ought to kick him out. Ride the fade, over route, curl route, drag. Xerox it right from five.
Too flat to the back. That one screws up.
Yeah, back too flat. Tackle the major bust. You can do a block of
it.
Yeah, well, the trap, it doesn't matter as much.
You can trap
the leg off from the trap. You have to come down. He's the main brain part. Called Ram, get a signal for hitch and go. For us, is a fish right here. Grab your mouth, hitch and go. So, out of Ram, drop back protection, what would he call? Not 60, because it's tight end again. Not 560, 260. If the 260-34. He threw that ball too far inside. He got called for holding. This is gap protection. It's these drawn lugs. This is C gap, B gap, A gap, all the way down to gap protection. See, they're blowing it ready for play now. Usually they do a little faster than that, but at least when we're ready, we blow it ready for play. Rio. What was the play here? Power, 27. You'll see 27-34. Yeah, that's the guy across his face. Yeah, they get a lot of movement. There's a twist and slant and all that stuff. But you ought to be able to plant that off.
Why is running back? That's power?
Here comes the guard around.
Okay, I see that.
See, he had his eyes wrong. He's still the pressure.
That's the pressure.
He don't have his eyes on him. You don't block him. When you're out of it, see him turn right here, see the tight cover. Just go. You block the linebacker. You don't block his hands. So. Watch his eyes. Hey, don't take a peek at him. Like, yeah, you're wrong. Go up here and block the linebacker. Linebacker went away, you can go get the safety. At least he did the right thing, not hesitating. Just go east and west. If there ain't no danger, keep running. Tackle somebody down. All right, we got, this is just a sweep there, our pipe. They used to cut out there, in and out. There's your Rocky. It's your short yard. Lock down, kick out. He had to press it further outside. See, there you go, he's getting off the hip. Right off the hip of 33. This is what we call ram hip. It's a ram formation. We take another fullback or a tight end, put him in the hip position, and all we do is full zone. This is 36.
we call 86, 36, but on the hip, they all know it don't matter what the front is, they full zone it all the way across, and we try to bang or bounce it. He tried to bend it, that's why he's wrong. So he called 36, 17, or 86 Roger, 86 Roger, and full zone it. Now this is Rip, Far, and Rocket was called. Okay, so we had all hitches, and they got mad across the board, so we gave them slant safety. So catch, throw. Throw was a little bit low here. Five-man protection, set, cut. Our first play is up. See, there's three slow right here. Our first play for sidelines is always an indie face. In other words, you know, the first play of the series, they always sprint out to and get lined up as quick as they can. So the first play is always an indie play. It's always indie tempo. So they would be graded down if not being ready. We had Rocky call. He looked at the sideline, began to give him a slant signal.
Should take the line along the line up, crap it out, same spot every time.
Exactly. He only went three steps. Let's go five. Five steps, show your numbers, and then go. Hitch and go. That's terrible. Quick game.
Center. They get a lot of two-handed stuff. The corners, a lot of two-handed, quick jam.
Oh, yeah. It's all two-handed. Also. But he's got our center. This is the first time he's ever played shotgun. He's terrible. He finally got a little better game of spring shotgun snap. But he had a tendency just to float it. I mean, just bring it back to him. That's what the old boy was doing yesterday. They almost snap it hard, and eventually he'll get his accuracy down. It's a poor fake out of the back end before the back. It's the same. He's got to cut across. First off, he's aligned too tight. Yeah, now we run that same 336. This is what we call it, ace formation. We don't run it very much, but if it's a man team, we run that same 336 with drag a tight end, curl, hitch, but we bring another tight end to run up a little bit across and serve as a pick guy. So he's gonna run across here at five, and he's gonna run across at four. Looks like a big old traffic jam in there. And so he's gonna get this guy picked off for him. Hell, they want to get out.
Run that back.
Get
extra guy now, too.
Yeah, our center, look at your center. We got a center on the vertical route. Them guys didn't call it. Them the ACC officials. All right. Yeah, watch our center. He's supposed to, all he's supposed to do is block back. He's blocked, turns the wrong way, he comes downfield. You're 16 on post route. Call jet. Face a slant. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, come back out. 1, 2, 3.
this is a good adjust, especially inside the 10-yard. We throw a bunch of slant routes. What we call jet, it looks like a slant. It goes three steps, and then it comes right back out. We scored a 4-state against it. This kid only went 3 and 2. You got to go 3 and really sell the slant for 3 and then come back out. Quarterback can take 3 steps and throw. Of course, this soft snap, screw it up. 1, 2, 3. This is 27, so real power. Signal was real, and then just power. And he called 27. And what happens is this guy winds up, like I said, we got all kinds of moves and stuff. He's only got a bunch of power. But it winds up being a wet call. So the guard ought to pull. When he pulled the wet call, he don't block the end man on the line of scrimmage. Got to cut that guy right here. Deep, at least once a quarter. 4 times a game, minimum, at least once a quarter. Go vertical. That's right. See, this is when they're kicking us. Puts in those guys. Zone drop, and we should just do the side adjustment out here. We'll get that later on.
You got some good zone blitz, though.
Yeah, but against us, you know, we kind of hurt them with the little. Here's that, that 89, the crease package, that was what we call bunch. This would be Leo bunch. They actually line up with two tight balls in the middle of the field. They should be lined up right out here.
They're like the club, we call clubs.
Right. Yeah, we don't even do that anymore. That was just a one chance deal. But we do this bunch. Now, we do this a good bit. A real, real bunch.
How far should they be out there?
Well, if the ball's on the left hash, they would be right. If the ball's in the middle, they should be about right here.
Between
plus five.
Split line up there and go.
Put them down
in the hash?
Yeah. Plus five outside the hash. And all this is non-package. He has an outside release vertical. So he's got to go. Keep going outside. He should chase outside even more. He has the stop route, that's the H. The Y is the H step out. It's like he always does. Look what happened.
That's our slice, is all that is.
Corner jump the stop route.
No jump?
Yeah.
And he sees it.
Pretty much, yeah.
And he goes behind you. It's 89 loaded. All five.
What red is that?
9
threes.
Crease, very tall.
Crease package out of bunch.
You ever pee make on that?
he can out. Four verticals.
Third package, three package.
Three packages.
That's a good little route up there.
Vertical, vertical, 2 yards outside the hash, 2 yards outside the hash, sneak drop. Alright, now wide up in cover three. And cover three, just play off the safety. Safety in the middle, he's a non-factor either way, there it is.
You've got to get it.
He's going to be three and throw. One, two, three and throw. Right through his hands.
You see a lot of dime.
More nickel than dime. Yeah, we don't see a dime because of, you know, the run game, but we see a lot of nickel.
Teams
in the NFL got five good DBs, so I know these. They put their fifth guy in, and that means he's a second teamer. We can put a second teamer in a game.
Get more pressure.
Here's a skinny package. This is open. Rocket skinny.
We'll have our quarterback kind of give a little fight to that.
What's that?
We got to give a little shoulder fake to the radar and then throw it. So, right.
Yeah, but I wouldn't go too long with a fake because he'll wind up throwing the timing drop. Right. What you want to do then, ideally, is after he's not sticking very good. Yeah. He's just throwing his hand up like some junior high guy or something. I'm open, Mom. Oh, yeah, I'm throwing to me. There you go, 5 steps and stick. And then after he goes 5 steps and stick, he takes 1 step, the ball would be on the flight.
That's the way we ran last year. We run that bubble so much, we call it bubble and go, and just pop and go. But
see, here he's going, the play's over. See, when the play is over, see how he's already starting to run. He's the Z. Where's the Z line up? Nine times out of ten. Wide side of the field, right? Play ended on this hash, go ahead and start running on over there because you're probably going to be on the other side. There's the quarterback looking, getting a signal. Of course, the linemen, you know, I'm sure we're all talking about them getting up, chasing the ball. That's where they're going to be anyway. Power. It is 27, call it right to the field. They got a little twist game going on there. Pitch off the end. G the guard around for the back. There you go.
Play.
Oh, hell. Put your eyes up on him. He's a little confused. That goes in the books. That's how you can throw for 80%. That's about the easiest pass play you'll ever complete.
That counts too, doesn't it? Backside tackle got B gap, right?
Yeah. Backside tackle? Yeah, he got to protect B gap. B gap protect and climb. Post drive, backside back. We actually got him an extra dude right here. Backside back. Playside back was all the way over here. See, you'll get very little, especially all the athletes. You'll get very little outside twist. Because if they get outside twist, you kill them on sprint out. So what they do is they get the ends wide when they do the inside game. Slant, twist, angle, and all that kind of stuff. Well, the power is, anytime you have a post drive technique, you're in pretty good shape against the twist or power because the tackle can stay there and protect. That was one of the reasons why we added it. And play. Think about the twist or the defensive advantage. Of course, that's just Rocky. When he calls Rocky, 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 when he calls Rocky Keep, he just says Rocky, Rocky, Rocky. He don't tell anybody but the back. Just so the back's not surprised when he doesn't get the ball.
And your short yardage, you like your line to get on the ball, right?
Yeah, there's the right guard and the left backside tight end to get up there. But he didn't tell anybody other than the back.
our defensive line, they roll every four plays, irregardless. They're rolling in and out, they're tired of it. Open formation, open right. See, in this scrimmage here, our top three tailbacks are out.
That's why we did a lot of no backs and tackles.
We didn't have any of our top three tailbacks. One of them was gone, was at a function, the other two were hurt. They were skinny. Terrible routes. No stick. Should be rocket protection, 5 minute cut.
Signal for 260.
Well, we don't even have to call it usually because on the Ram, he knows it's going to be the drop back.
Got it.
Ram or line.
If you have to drop back pass out of Ram or line, it's going to be 260.
Got it. Well, we give him this gap signal just in case. He doesn't give him a gap signal.
There's never a time out of a real river there that you
260, no.
Got it.
Either 60 or 560. Oh, that was a slip screen in the back. Right.
That was kicking pretty consistent.
Oh, it did. Yeah, the last one we made the screen. Now we're in a Ram formation. All our linemen are down. We're together except the open side tackle. Where is that 2 point stand? That's so we can vertical set easier and drop back pass.
Why would you put all the rest of them down in the gun?
What's that?
Why would you put them down in the gun?
Because we could, most of the time we're running our run game or zone play. Some of that stuff. Okay. Our toughest guys, they open that tackle when we bought when we get a gap protection. So it just makes it easy for me. There's a vertical. That's a bad snap, but it's just 1, 2, 3 and throw. 1, 2, 3 and throw. We got a bad snap. Actually dropped that ball. Now we run a verticals out of Ram and line. We call the vertical package go. It's just a 3-man vertical. A Y is the middle field. The X is outside vertical. The Z is outside vertical. So if they have a shooting move, you can actually hit the Y down the middle. When we call it, it's usually a throw to the end, to our bell cow, our best guy. But we could throw it to the Y. I don't want to have that ball. He threw that ball too far inside. So. See, we're doing it again. See, watch your corner get tired. He just made a play. He tried to make a play. We ran it again, vertical, vertical. He's deep.
Oh, that might have thrown up behind him.
He's a lot faster than him. But here, gap protection, you know, this is just that zone blitz cover for. Look at all that crazy stuff. Guy coming in there, the big con dropping out of the blitz right there. You know, your jabs. What you talk about making a play on the deep ball? That's what I mean. Making a play on the deep ball when you're fresh, you're making one when you're tired.
Put that guy. Yeah.
Yeah, because 23 just ran, he's tired. 1, 2, 3 and throw. Throw it outside, give it a chance.
So if that ball's in, you have to put 23 back in there and call over again.
Yeah.
23 come right back in there next play.
And if we cut it, 23 goes back up in there and that quarterback and that corner line looks 20 yards deep this time, we just go cook. Yeah, see, we're doing a lot of ace on this because we didn't have any tailbacks. This was actually a hitch call to tapping.
He's tapping. He's got press coverage.
That'll be catch and throw. No, we had hooks called and tapping, so it's a 3 and throw.
260.
fall or spring, and this is more for a man coverage team, what we do is we slip the back underneath. They block five-man protection. Line adjust block is five-man protection. And our wideouts crack. Man coverage, we crack, figuring they'll take their man down there. Well, they're in zone here, so he's got to crack the ladder to get that guy. So we still crack, but it's man or zone. And back and slip out. But it's better versus man. It's going to be just a man call for us. We'll check to it versus man coverage. Rip far. Junior college. Four and ACT.
Yeah, Ron, I talked about that.
Yeah. Reading on fourth grade level. He did. This is how bad it was now. This guy's practiced it for a week and a half. Yeah, he's doing all right. We started at guard, and then we moved to tackles. Tackle was easier. Still with our three or four practices, and Ron comes and says, "You're not going to believe it." I said, "What?" He said, "We were calling 89, and he was blocking all 80s, no matter where what the play was." And I said, "What about Roger Lewis?" He said, "He didn't think that meant anything." So he was blocking 89 Roger and 89 Louis the same. He said, "What's that Roger Louis mean?" Oh, shit. Yeah, so you can't assume, you know, that's what I said. You can't assume anything, your kids or our kids. I think this is just a hook, yeah. Rip far. Yeah, right tackle.
Be right on him, see, coach.
Yeah, but if we have
a hook, you just don't run.
Not time to
run. Hooks or hitches, you just don't run.
He just don't do that bad. Yeah, tackle, right tackle is an NBM, right? I think Ron's going to yell at him. Here's Limbo, here's Rambo and Limbo real quick. You can tell it's ending because we just barely got it on tape. Limbo, hit the out. See, they're running over to chase the cover. See the left tackle? What is he doing? He's supposed to zone reach. He's purple setting. Brady. He's going to wide open quarterback pocket. This is zone reach. Now you know what's wrong with working with it. Don't assume our guy's a whole lot smarter than yours, because they ain't. This kid's daddy is Jim Washington. He coaches for the Titans.
Oh, really? He played at Arkansas?
Mm-hmm. His brother plays at Arkansas.
What number is he?
Brady, 77.
Yeah.
Don't I have no football sense. Oh, man.
Jim used to recruit here when he was at Arkansas.
Is that right?
Yeah. And he went to Houston.
Yeah, he went to Houston, then he got on with the Titans. And things worked out great for him. Here's Ogun Wright. This one, when we knew we had to go to the finger, his wife's a leg kid. And then they stem. So we said we just give him.
Right,
huh? Yeah, we had a little arrow, didn't we?
You just give him the finger.
Oh, no, we got a... This is up. We got up, it's called the up package. And with scat, we should have had him doing a shoot.
Wow.
A 2D look.
Yeah.
We got him scatting. Quarterback, you don't want to throw the ball. they're coming, we're just checking Rocket Bow. And this is the back. This is actually fifth wide. He did a good job here. Quarterback just told him it's Rocket. The back, it has no responsibility or protection. He just told him to stay. Stay in and block to help out. They're running bow package. Four step out, vertical, vertical, four step out. Just pitch and catch. Wide open. He's a plus. He can't play dead in Washington. Trap, three technique, well, I don't have a play, let's see, twisted, we just cave him down in there, and we'll go ahead and bring around the outside. Wide out, think he'll block, that's probably 81, so I'm gonna take two. Okay, now here's that same zone blitz, and this one, I mean, they're just running in regards to formation. We got guys uncovered. We didn't check out because we're gonna flood the zone anyway, right? So just take it, throw the stop route. Change the play to something. We got man coverage. Dark flip. I think he wound up calling, for some reason, he called 23. It's got to be the one technique, so it's got to be 22. And see, it's kind of against, see, this is kind of against the rules. So, because we really shouldn't run weak, or shouldn't run the play because of why? There's 4 weeks. Full week, right? But I kind of know with this defense here, this is an old Nebraska defense, like an old swarm front, where they got this guy has him man-to-man. So I lined up and I kind of knew that. Man coverage. With the dart, with the flip action, we get him out of position far enough to have a positive play. But normally we don't want to run that full week. See, he's unblocked. He makes a play. The reason he makes a play, because he's 4 weeks. They actually got him enough, gave us enough room. Now, if you run it out of the ramming line, the dart, the tight end needs to protect on the backside end. Because you don't read out of the ramming line. We don't read that end because you got a tight end protect. So he ought to protect him, protect the B gap. First down. It's a short yardage play. Second and two, third and two, goal line. The jumper. We always go in your face with it fast. You know, when it's a zone, there's no man, there's no call. It's just it's full zone. It's really not a real good stick. You need to see how he just, I mean, he's a little undisciplined. That's why this can't be a first rounder next year. But if you're hard to get drafted in the second round, if he gets disciplined running routes, it'll be a first rounder. Is that your open? Open, right? Yeah. He's a stick and lean. He's leaning that side and he comes across.
That's skinny.
Skinny. Rocket skinny. Now this was 4:30. obviously, you know, this formation, we're heavy, 90% half run, so we just run 4.36, block the run. The route is the same, but it's 3.36. Except more on the hip, now on the hip we drag him, we send a tight end vertical. So I think we need to get off, we'll change that back to tight end drag. But give your negatives and stuff, we do it a little lot. What's your name, Marlon? Show him the open hand. Ram him, and that's just the zone. He comes out with other lines. What the first thing to look for on a watch team on defense is how late do their defensive linemen get down the stance? Do they have their hands on their hips? If they do, in either case, that means MO4 is actually in shape, ready to play. Like we'll play some teams, Cincinnati, whoever, even Syracuse. We played Syracuse a couple years ago. MO4 boys had their hands on their hips. They'd be barely down getting their stance. I said, hey, guys, in shape. Now, you played Army, them some bitches are 4-point stance waiting on you. Bring it on, buddy. We've been training for 4 hours this morning. That's where we started. We done marched 8 miles. This is a piece of cake. And they're only about 235 pounds, but them suckers are in shape.
You can get that with Jack.
Yeah, 4 or 5 miles.
Remember that fullback we had?
Yeah, I remember that.
He's a great Green Beret, special forward. Yeah, 4 or 5 miles.
I was telling her the bear front, that's what you see on the goal line. The best play is against the bear. The power's okay. The speed option, toss sweep. This is Rip. Play is here. Okay, this is a switch package. This is a man, you know, when you get a lot of man coverage, you're obviously worried about rub offs. So on the switch package, this I ran this a bunch. Well, I ran more gloves than I did here. All he does is he has a landmark 10 yards deep. Outside or discover three, the X is getting a quick throw between 5 and 8 yards. You can just pop it right there, almost like a slant route. All right, if this guy plays over the top, or it's cover three, then he will pull up at 10 yards. That's what we kill people with, especially in Glone, with the pull up. They play cover three, and he run behind, and he just pull up at 10 yards, turn inside the quarterback. Our quarterback's timing, I didn't show you this route here today, but our quarterback's timing is a catch, look for the quick throw. If it ain't there, then take a quick three, read it. Now, if he's going to go deep, in other words, if right here, man coverage, if his guy gets rubbed off in the mesh, after he meshes, he throws his hand up. Let the quarterback go, and I'm gone. I'm going deep. So watch what happens. He gets picked off on the mesh. Throw your hand up. I'm going deep. And quarterback, he puts too much air on. He got to put a little less air on that right there. But it's the same old deal. When man coverage, you got two wideouts, Todd, to the side, you got man coverage. They better do what?
They better be on different levels.
They better be on different levels, right?
Yeah.
See, these guys are on a different level.
Yeah.
So we tell the quarterback, if it's man, same level, somebody's getting rubbed.
That's right.
And that's what happened.
Well, that wasn't that crap. Is that cornerback done? I mean, terrible. It had him, too. That's the one that bit on the play action.
Yeah, he's a freshman. He had a bad day. He got bad at this course. Did they see our boys getting down late? Yeah, boy.
Look at this thing.
Lazy wives, man. Tired.
That ball. He ain't getting out that ball very good either. They were like, go.
Tired.
They get tired. I like it, little coach six.
He's a tough one.
We don't got fat little kid.
Fat, dummy looking, sorry, slow. He gets catch the ball. And he knows this. He knows his ability. He's one of those guys. You know,
that's it.
You catch the ball, he's going to run right up the field. Ain't going to dance. He ain't going to get what's there. This is it, that line here. Especially when this play is the most effective, when they get tired. Like, we run and get a big play or whatever, we like to jump right in there, especially. hit 56. This full zone, hand the ball off, and just run right here. Like I said, he presses the outside, hits the tackle, and just run the daylight.
Your switch route, that's your six back.
Six right. Back. I think this was limbo. Yeah, open. Yeah, I got run out. There you go. Got pressed back into the 3-yard marker. Better off just throwing a hitch or a thing. Hitch or a radar. You don't want to throw a slant, even though right here it looks like it's cover zero. It's not. It's zone blitz. You don't want to throw a slant into the vehicle.
You got thirds. If you go package tickets, it's any type of two-beam safety, whether it be quarters or halves, then you want to shoot.
Yeah, we have four verticals. We have slick. We have a wild. I'm tubing in. That's what we do with the up.
Right.
We call up, we shoot it, or we're scatting.
Right.
Based on whether it's a single safety or two safety.
Right. Or man cover. You see a lot of birds in here?
Yeah.
Really? You have to.
Barely like
two. How do you line up?
You stay in three,
three and two.
If you stay in too deep, then you got a guy in cover. Or you only got four in a box and you're going to draw on that.
Yeah, if they're playing, they can't play staying too deep. They have to be a man. No way they stand too deep unless they totally displaced their linebackers because of the numbers.
What about one nine?
There's a mix.
Yeah.
Here's the power. This guy's a little bit gimpy, but here's he's running. It might have been 27 call. Yeah. But you want to run away from four, you know, they got four guys over here. And no linebackers over here, so we got 3-on-2. We got numbers. We all have a play. Here comes the power. Follow the snap or the pitch. Pull around on the backer. If we're hitting up the ball with the pitch, probably the power. Yeah. Power, we gain 10 more yards. Stay in B gap, right guard. wideout is screwed up. See, he shouldn't do this unless the quarterback tells him to do this. He just had the buzz. He should be blocking it. So we're okay with the player. Full week. He reads the end. The end came inside, but if there's a twist, he'll see a white jersey outside. If you see a white jersey outside, you're fine. The right guard's free. This is a red formation. Oh, this was a slip screen to the back, and he didn't run. The brain part. All right, hit him right back in the head. Go hard. Ain't hurt. Sometimes if you want to get JT out in the field, you send Ram to the boundary and run your verticals. Now you got a little bit more room to operate out there, Brian. He's a little slow off the ball right here. But all this is Ram 263. My formation, like
throw the vertical coming out.
Yeah. Oh, my hammy, see? There's Todd. Start tightening up until you realize it wasn't going to catch you. Then all of a sudden it got tight.
He come out running one way.
One, two, three, and throw. He thought he pushed out, but he just went on top of it. He didn't know how to play the deep ball.
He calls faster. Back there.
They ever put two guys out there on that guy? It's like
ouch. There.
They ever give him any help out there?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they'll get a lot of double. When they're doubling, they're outnumbered in the run game or they're outnumbered. That's what helps, you know, on the power play. When you cheat the free safety over the X, you have no run support from the safety on the power play.
Right.
You know what I mean? So you kind of get them one with another. When we get him to double our X, then we got everything to the Y side of the field. Trips, 89, you know, our power plays, the field, and all that kind of stuff. Watch this kick, man. I don't think he gets this ball up. He hits it a couple times. Ooh, line drive.
It's all that guy's elbow standing there.
Yeah. Alright, let's see how high this ball gets.
Golly. It's 71.
It's 71 on the ass. Boys, that was our starting kicker last year. The guy that missed the field goal the last play of the game before state. I told Tom, and it was 4th and 1. I said, he said, let's kick it. Go to overtime. I said, do what? Kick it. You kidding me?
I followed. And you missed it,
huh? Yeah. 37 yard. Let's go for it. 4th and 1. All right, sorry, hit play call. Play action pass, brother. He's going for the kill. You get too many opportunities to beat them boys. If we run the crease out of a random line, sometimes we run with a tight end to get help on the edge. Then it becomes a 6-step out. Everybody else is saying vertical, hitch or slant. And it becomes a 6-step out instead of an 8-step. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And he's kind of squaring it off too much. I'd rather his feet cut it out. Quarterback will throw it on 5-step. See if he throws on 5. Catch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. Pretty good time.
Outside guys vertical.
Outside for outside release every time. 100%. Tighten the coverage, lower the throw. Should do that one a little bit lower. Thank you. what, Indy 9, same call. We had a couple big plays on this in the last few years. Indy 9 trail. This is the trail package off that Indy 9. He should be wide. He should be at the bottom of numbers. Anytime we sprint out to Z, he's the bottom of numbers. Now, he's going to run, instead of running vertical, outside release, and run a 9-step thick. In other words, outside release, and run a thick post. 9-step through. He's going to run just like he would a crease, 6 steps and out, but he's going to go 6, 5, and then up. So he'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, look out, and then turn it up the sideline. And they're jumping it out like right here, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 5. We had Virginia, we hit it on 3rd and 30. And Jordan Welch about quit. 3rd and 30, hit the trail. Changers. We want changers back. See how we're already, the play's over? Everybody's still getting lined up. Officials still running the place. We got to be set. Come on, get ready. Yeah, something happened. Took too long. See, we called limbo. We waited around too long. We allowed them to get set. It's coming away. And you know that's a rule now. When you break contain, last year we got called for it twice. Break contain, we threw the ball out of bounds. Up in the stand. Y'all on the field, they caused intentional grounding. I knew that was screwed up, but this year they changed the rule. If you break contain, your quarterback can throw it away out of bounds. You throw 12 rows up in the bleachers, but the ball's got to be beyond line of scrimmage. But that's the NFL rule. You know, protect the quarterback, let him throw it away. Left tackle screwed up there. Well, we got limbo, and he's going to make a solid, solid, solid. Let him know I'm here to help you. On the outside guy, you can stay on the end. Lock on the end, I'll get the outside guy. Here's real bunch. Here's where the lineman would be. The ball on the hash, he's 1 yard outside the hash. That's the Z, that's the Y, that's the H. Here comes that zone blitz being called. See, this is before we did the side adjustment with the wideouts. He ought to be giving these guys the radar signal. If that guy blitz, he's just going to turn and throw it to him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Here's that up with the fake and the shoot. See, there's safety in the middle, so we already should shoot him. We should spot him up or scat him. Then he busts it. He should go 3 steps and stop, like this guy. See, that's where he's really speaking. He can save all that energy. Instead of running 30 yards, just did 3 steps. One thing about when you tell your quarterback your timing, 3 and 2 hitches, all right? And if you're gone, the ball's gone, if nobody's open, that probably means they dropped everybody. You got all kinds of room to run. Now here on the up, he has to count his first step up as a hitch. Then he goes 3. That's hitch up, 1, 2, 3, hitch up, and then take off. They're dropping 8 guys. That boy's trying to make it. He tried to say he had it. Yeah, they got called for offsides for about 3 or 4 times already.
Okay.
It was a pitch net. You know what he did, how he got him offsides? He was watering.
Yeah.
They were tying up on a snap, and so he was giving them some water, and them dudes were just jumping. So now, what happened? They got off the ball, so who wins? We win, right? We done got what we wanted, we got them off the ball.
Yeah, it's a slant to this.
Yep, we got a trap. We're trapping the nose is tight, so we're trapping with the center. read, so you get out of it. Because you gotta make your calls, you gotta make your play call so fast. And then you get a quick 5 second window or so where if you're gonna change your play, you gotta decide to change it. You don't wanna mill around and think, well, should I change it, should I not, and you gotta go with it. Here was Rams. See how it happened here? We took too long. But this guy was uncovered, so we're checking Rambo. He's going kind of spastic on me. 1, 2, 3, roll.
What's your signal for Rambo?
Tying a thing around there like that movie. That's the Stallone.
Yeah, limbo.
His left arm limp. When they hear it, they know it's automatic at any pace. All right, here is a naked off counter, which we could do, or we'll probably do it now, just a dart, we just pull the tackle. He's supposed to slam and go to flat, he's got a curl, and he's got a seam. Look at the backside safety. He's hanging there for run support to the fake. Look at the seam right here. Just get off of him and get in the seam. That's what we hit against Florida State in the second half, about 40 yards. True negative. Exchange. They got to run full speed through the end zone, then they jog back, and they get in the middle field, they run, then they go to the other half, and they run another play. So we do that so we'll incorporate our exchange into that. And then if we have any new plays or anything to kind of walk and talk through, whatever, all right, like defensive fronts and all that kind of stuff, we'll do that at that 15-minute period as well. So we might do 5 or 10 minutes of walk and talk, showing them this is what the defensive front's going to be, show the scout team what it's going to be like, and all that kind of stuff, and then we'll do 5 minutes. Any trick plays we're going to add that week, we usually add a trick play or two every week, we do during 15 minutes before practice. As those practice starts, it's all moving again. So it's exchange, PTO, or walkthrough. But we're always out 15 minutes before practice starts. This will be trick plays, fronts, whatever. But we want to make sure we get some kind of exchange, quarterback centers, running backs, done prior to practice. All right. Now, if we had a meeting time, say we usually meet, but that was the case, depending on class, we got a 4-hour block of time. 2 to 6. We might say it might be 2:15 to 6:15. And then, you know, we'll say, well, if you're out of class early, you come up at 2:15 minutes extra or something.
But how long does that meeting there go on at?
This one here? It's about 45 minutes.
45 minutes.
You got to go good 45 minutes. You get about 15 minutes to get your stuff on, get out on the field, and put your shoes on, and be off the field ready to go. Now, quarterbacks, different. Anytime, the first 3:15 here, we're always 10 minutes prior to that, so it's 3:05. So we'll be always 10 minutes of throwing and catch. We'll get all our warm-ups and throwing it down before that. Not the quarterbacks. So I got less meeting time with them, but we made it up on them. I'm down early. Volunteer time. So. The way we practice, like say, I don't have a practice schedule. I can send you one of our practice schedules. But we'll do the first 15 minutes of practice is always for our special teams. It's always extra points, field goal, 5 minutes, and punt for 10. Every day. While that 15 minutes is going on, a punt, it's about 15 minutes. It might be long, it's untimed, right? But it's usually about extra point, field goal, punt. The old linemen, people that aren't involved in that, which is usually all the old linemen, all right, quarterbacks, and most of the wide receivers. Any skill guys? All any of the skill guys are with us, and we do quick game throws. Kind of like you were doing yesterday, we line up in the formation, we throw hitches, we throw slants, we throw skinnies, whatever. We got about 10 minutes, 15 minutes of that. We have them all. We have about all the wideouts when we do this. They have all the quarterbacks. When we go punt, we lose a few of the wideouts that are on the punt team, but we have everybody else on the team. So we'll have tight ends here and throw arrows. We'll have backs here and throw scats or sneaks, whatever. But all we're doing is we're doing all the quick throws for 15 minutes. The old linemen, they're already started during the vigil. Sometimes Ron will go out 15 minutes before then and start doing his ladders and shoes and all that stuff. But those are the first 15 minutes of practice. In the spring, that's period 1, 2, and 3. In the fall, we don't time it because it might take a little bit longer to install and go over the pump protection. Whatever. So in the fall, we went period 1. It starts right with individual. So if we would have 24 periods on a heavy day, I'm talking about a full pad day, if we have 24 periods, we probably would have, let's say, have some offensive team, more backwards, 24, 23, 22, 24. Let's Reggie always wants 40 minutes, 45 minutes of team. He likes more team than I do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Team of 60 there. And then skeleton, I'm never comfortable with this, but we usually only have about 20 minutes of skeleton. But our 20 minutes of skeleton, we'll get 30 minutes of plays. In other words, most of the 5 minute period, what I'll script is set is this is how I script. I can send you our practice schedule. But if you had a 5 minute period of skeleton, I 1, 2, 3, 4. I have a play. And then I circle 1, 2, and 3. So 2s repeat the first 3 plays. So I script 7 plays basically for every 5 minutes. I only script 4. And the 2s just repeat the first 3. Now, I always mention at the 2s, how can you make a mistake? You're just repeating the same plays the ones just did earlier. Both the team and skeleton, that's what I do. Time and you want them running the same plays as the one. So we do all that. Well, I do that 1, 2, 3. For skeleton team, I'll script that. And for inside, too, I script inside, I script everything. But we'll wind up getting about 10 11 plays in 5 minutes. So what happens is We go against the defense, I don't script the coverage. They play whatever they want. That's the regular scale against
for a 20-minute scale, how many plays do you say you script?
I'll script 1, 2, 3. I'll script 4 for the regular periods, and then I'll script an extra 4 because I'll get through all these in the first 15 minutes easy. So I'll script me 2 periods, script me an extra period for the end, and I usually have time after that to get 2 or 3 more in unscripted. So for a four period thing, I'll script a 5 period set. And I'll get through those pretty quick. That's against the defense. So that's unscripted coverage wise. They'll do whatever they want. I just want fast on fast. Right now, 10 minutes before then, I'll do a scout, 10 or 15. It's usually in. That's just our offense against the scout skeleton. It's like going against air and hell. That's what things they don't know how to cover anybody. They just tell the kid to cover 3, cover 4, whatever. That's scout skeleton.
Is that pass?
Yeah, it's all pass. You know, you're 7-on-7. But, you know, it's against the scout, so.
And the other skeleton you're talking about, is that running versus defense, or is that running?
No, that's all pass. Skeleton is 7-on-7. Quarterbacks, wide outs,
defense, right?
Yeah. Quarterbacks, running backs, wide outs, tight ends.
Okay.
And I'll script in that skelly. I might script 5 minutes of red zone skeleton inside the 20, or 5 minutes coming out on my 3-yard line or something. It'll give you some situational stuff, just like everybody does there. And now, 1 through 9 is individual. Right? But I'll take, like, period right here. 9, 8, 9, period 8, 9, I'll do Indy. For the entire offense. If we don't have inside, like if it's a full pad day though, like we'll have 3 periods of inside. Let's see, 7, 8, 9 will be your inside or you don't know what you call middle drill, you know, just your heavy
inside run.
Inside run. All right. That's against the defense. So we'll go against the defense with that. I don't like to go against a scout or a scout. We'll go against the defense with that. And so out of that 7, 8, 9, all right, half that, 7.5 minutes, is their emphasis. So we'll run their plays, what they want for that week. So they'll be looking at cards. If we have a play that the opponent runs, we'll run that. But usually looking at a card. So they'll get our good people running against it. Then the last 7.5 minutes of that is our emphasis offensively. And Herb or our defense will tell them what front to be in. So we really only get half of this inside period. So that leaves 1 through 6. Now if that's the case, and this is normally the case on Tuesdays and Wednesdays, and we're going to go against each other for that 15 minutes. So 1 through 6 will be individual. And the way our individuals, I'll get one. Period 1, I'll go with the tight ends. Period 2, I'll go with the running backs. Sometimes 2 and 3. And then 3 through 6 is with the wide receivers. I'm talking about quarterback. Now what Rob will do with the tight ends and the running backs, usually you'll take 2 periods, 5 to 6, or 3 periods, 4, 5 to 6, and go more inside run.
And then what he's doing is half line and then down.
Half line, run, polish, that kind of stuff. All of that individual period. Now, what we'll do is say this is the way it works right here, 79. Now, I'll do the first 10 minutes of team at Indy. We'll come down and we'll do 17 or 18 is Indy. And all I do with the Indy is I'll take one offense, put them out on about the 35-yard line. Herb will be out to the GA value with the scout team. Front 7, not the secondary. Front 7 is to get them in the front. And we'll run 5 or 6 inning plays, score a touchdown. 2 to go up, run 5 or 6 plays, score. And we'll do that 2 or 3 reps, and I'll move inside. I'm just going to go to 21, take 3 plays, score, and all that. I'll try to get about at least 4 drives in with each group on 16, 3, 16, 17. All every play is going to be an indie tempo. We'll sub from the sidelines. I'll have the headsets on. We'll do the whole 9 yards. And then this will be regular team versus scouts. And then in this, now in this script, at least I don't script this. this is all scripted, but there'll be Indy plays sprinkled into here as well. I mean, our team, when our team gets scouts, is a pretty high tempo. That's what I mean. Our scout team's got to, they got to get lined up. You got to help it. You got to get going. So you got to have more than one coach helping with the scout team.
So you'll go inside run against each other, and you'll go pass several steps against each other. That's about it, right?
That's it. Now, Tulane, we didn't have as many bodies. The private school couldn't have any walk-ons. So this team period right here, not 16 and 17, but this team period right here was against each other, and it was self-serve. It would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It would be half defensive emphasis and half offensive. So the first 3.5 period, we're running what they want, running the cards, whatever. If we're playing a 4-wide team or something, they'll let us run our plays. But we're doing whatever they want for 20 minutes or 15 and a half minutes. And then the last 15 and a half minutes, we tell them what we want. So we had less time. But I like it because we had good on good. We got just about this much done. That's how basic our practice works. But we devote that 10 minutes. At some point in that practice schedule, that 10 minutes is going to be. Now, Ron gets a lot of his individual before practice. During this 15 minutes of special teams, and sometimes 15 minutes for that, because he's got a lot of individuals. He'll get a lot of his individuals done. Now, when we're going versus pass skeleton versus the defense, that's when he goes pass rush. Good on good. You know, D lineman and L lineman, that's when he gets his one-on-one pass pro, two-on-two or two-on-three pass pro, and all that kind of stuff is when that's going on. And like tight ends, for instance, I'll use the tight ends. If we had a 20-minute pass skeleton period, I'll tell the tight end coach, well, I'll use your guys the first 10 or 15 minutes. You take the last 10 and you go down the wrong.
Way there when he quit lifting before practice and go individual. They make for their offensive line. Let them lift after practice. Them.
Yeah, see, we lift, our lifting during the season, because they lift during the season, that's volunteer time. They come in before class, they come in at lunchtime, they come in before the meetings, they come in and get their strength coaches. They work, you know, they got 45 minutes today. You got to come in before 2 o'clock. Now, 2 days, they bring it in after practice. Like the morning practice, though after the morning practice, a certain group has to come in and do their lifts.
They get more individual time.
Yeah. Everybody's always bitching for individual, just like all positions, because they want more individual. So that's how we kind of break it down. We don't get as much individual as we want. Shoot, glove over. I'd have that there. We didn't have no 4-hour time limit. And they wouldn't want to check on us. And what I will do is on the right after practice, if there's a route or something that we've not thrown well during that day, we're not throwing the blow, we're not throwing the slant, not throwing the takeoff, whatever, then we'll take off and just work on that one route for 5 or 10 minutes. You hope the kids will stay on after all some, but that's, I've had kids that have done that, and kids that have, and I wish they more of them stay on their own afterwards. But I don't harp on them as much to stay afterwards. I just kind of encourage them. They do have something. If they throw something bad during the practice, the skinny or something, then I'll make the wide out quarterback stay for 5 minutes and get that time down. Now we do the, what the circle of death is, don't you? What we do on Mondays.
Yeah.
How we grade the loaves. We have, we grade. When we grade them, there's 3 things we look for offensively when we grade them. One is a play grade, that they execute their assignment, their technique, and all that. The other is an effort grade, going full speed. And the third thing is if they're soft ass. I mean, if they were just turning something down, those are 3 criteria where they can get graded on. So, yeah, softies.
Softies.
Well, for we have a essay after a game. Remember, on Monday after practice, we have the whole offense get together and they get in a big circle. All the guys are in a circle. And we count every guy that had a number of loaf on the team. Like, say my name is Woody Ganson. And he had 3 loafs. 3 times he was lazy, loafed on the field. All right, he'll come call him out in the middle of the circle. And say, my name is Woody Ganson. I let the team down 3 times. Everybody do 3 up-downs for him. Up-down, up-down. another guy come in there, my name is Jackie Robinson, I let the team down 5 times. Oh, I said, Jackie, everybody gets it five. Fat boys get up in there, I had 2 fat twins called the Cheeseburger Twins. I had bacon cheeseburger, double cheeseburger. And them boys is just flat out lazy. And then one of them had 20-some loaves, and one of them had 30 loaves, and they quit the next week. And man, this guy, you did what? Dude, we had one last 2 weeks ago. I was pissed. I counted. I now not only made them do the loaf circle, I made them do for every missed assignment, and every time they were soft. And cost. Those guys were having 10 or 12 apiece, and we wound up doing 370 of them. So it was 45 minutes after practice. They were wore out. But that low circle, we call it the circle death, it gets the peer pressure. Guys will run to the ball, they won't stand around a pile, they'll, you know, wideouts will go full speed off the ball, all that kind of stuff. So we call it the circle death. If a guy comes down and he has none, they say, my name's Woody Dess, I'll let the team down 0 times, everybody clap 1 time. Amazing. As they get older, you know, they kind of know, hey, you know, they're going to watch that film and see who's loafing. I don't want to be called.
Does everybody go to the middle?
Everybody that played. Everybody that was in the scrimmage, everybody that was in the game, right, goes in the middle. We call everybody out. I only do it for big for scrimmages and games. I don't do it for practice. We grade in practice, but we do grade. Now, we do grade every practice. When we go team, we grade for circle, for loafs. MAs and softs, and then after that practice, after the next day's practice, their individual coach gets it. Whatever he wants to do. You can do up downs, crawl up, you can do grass drills, but we grade it every day. Every team practice we have, we grade for loafs, MAs, and softs. And then after the next practice, their individual coach will get it. Now, if it's a scrimmage or a game, then I get them. I get them all for that. So, hey, I had one freshman. The freshman don't understand. I'm a big old freshman. I think he had 15. My name's Greg Walker. I said, you got 15? He said, hey, coach, you must have counted wrong. And you're like, oh, what did he say that? Yeah, you're right. You had 35. And that was it. You know, 35. He kind of likes to do that every day. The place where you're, he's on the headset with me. When he hears a formation, he helps get him in. That's what he does. Now, when I'm on the headset, I don't run.